Welcome to Foam University. Today we're going to talk about some spray foam problems. Now I know what you're thinking. You have a spray foam project coming up, you've been doing some online research, maybe you've checked out the YouTubes a little bit, and you're starting to see a lot of these spray foam nightmares. I get it, it can be very, very frightening. There's a lot of horror stories out there about spray foam applications gone wrong. You might have heard about things like some terrible odors that just won't go away, issues with the foam ultimately having to be removed, things like that. Well, all of those problems typically stem from three different things, and we're going to talk about those right now. The first thing is poor application. 95% of issues with spray foam all come from poor application by the sprayer. Now, spray foam can be a tricky thing. The temperatures have to be just right. There are several machines inside the trailer, if it's a high pressure system, that if anything is off, usually that trailer is designed to shut itself down. It's designed to where it will not let itself spray bad foam. However, sometimes, you know, especially if a sprayer may not be using a trailer with all that type of equipment, anyways, spray foam can still come out poorly sometimes, or if the applicator is not laying it right, or if he's laying it too thick, or if the passes are too wide, if it's not curing properly, if it's not adhering to the substrate properly. Again, all these different issues that ultimately stem from poor application. The next thing to think about is poor education. Now, this one, to be honest, falls on the customer or the homeowner. You should be educated on your project in particular, the product that's being used, and the contractor that's installing it. So you should, if the contractor cannot supply you with information about the exact product they're putting in, if they can't explain why they're using this particular product for your particular project, that could be a red flag. So again, you should educate yourself on what your specific situation calls for and make sure that you are working with a contractor that is on the same page as you. And the last thing is poor expectation. Now, this ultimately comes from miscommunication between the contractor and the customer. Now, at the end of the day, most of the time people re-insulate a project, either a house, barn, whatever, for energy costs. That's a big thing. Comfort is also a big thing. Now, if your expectations are misaligned with what the contractor actually thinks will take place, there's inevitably going to be issues. Now, again, it's crucial that you and your contractor are both on the same page, the product that's being used, and the results that this is going to yield. If it's energy bills, if it's comfort, whatever your goals are, both of you need to be on the same page. So again, almost all spray foam nightmares can be avoided with a proper application. Make sure you hire a good contractor with experience that has the knowledge of several different products and knows which one your specific situation calls for. Good education, so make sure you do your homework as a consumer on the different types of products that are out there, what your type of project calls for, and make sure you're prepared for that. And lastly, make sure the expectations that you have can be reached by the contractor and the product that they're using. Hope you found this information helpful. Please like the video, leave us a comment, tell us about an experience with your project, or if you're in the education process, ask us questions down in the comments about, you know, some questions you may have about the best product to use, what your situation is, let us know. Also, subscribe to the channel. Make sure you see all these videos. The best way to do that is to hit that bell button. Thanks, guys. If you guys have ever wondered what I'm holding during these videos, it's actually one of our guides, the ultimate guide to foam insulation. This one happens to be for existing homes. We also have one for pole barns, as well as one for new homes. These are also downloadable on our website. Check it out.